ஓம் அஸ்மத் குருபியோ நமஹா. ஜெய் ஸ்ரீமன்னாராயணா. இட் வாஸ் எ வில்லேஜ். எ போர் மேன் நேம் சேஷயா லிவ்ட் இன் தட் வில்லேஜ். தெர் வாஸ் எ ஃபாரஸ்ட் நியர் பை. ஸோ ஹி யூஸ் டு லீட் ஹிஸ் லைஃப் ஆஸ் எ வுட் கட்டர். ஹிஸ் வைஃப் லக்ஷ்மி லெட் கண்டென்டட் லைஃப் வித் ஹர் ஹஸ்பண்ட் அண்ட் சன் பீமா. பீமா டிட் நாட் வாண்ட் டு கோ டு ஸ்கூல். ஹி யூஸ் டு அக்கம்பனி ஹிஸ் ஃபாதர் அண்ட் வாஸ் ஹெல்பிங் ஹிம் இன் கட்டிங் பிரான்ச்சஸ் ஆஃப் த ட்ரீஸ். Seshaya did not want his son remain as an illiterate like him. Thus, Bhimaya was forcibly sent to school. Once teacher called Seshaya and complained about his son. What, Seshaya, your son is not at all interested in studies. How can he get through his exams unless he pays attention? Seshaya was worried about his son. He called him and said, My dear son Bhima, why don't you understand our feelings? Is it not because of your well-being I am struggling hard? Do you want to remain as a woodcutter like me? I am an illiterate. Me and your mother want to see you as an educated person. Please fulfill our dreams. Bhima replied, Dad, I don't want to study. If you want, you go and study, and I will go and do your work. Saying so, he went out to play. Son's words were lingering in his mind. My son is insisting me to study at this age. Yes, when I am interested in studies, why don't I start now? He made up his mind to learn alphabets during night time. He called his son and said, If I study, will you also continue your studies? Bhima said, Oh, okay, yes, yes. Of course, he said it unintentionally. That moment became an auspicious time for Seshaya to start his studies. Morning time he was working, and at night he was going to the same master to learn alphabets. Because of his strong determination and interest in studies made him learn within no time. Gradually he was able to read and write. He was also practicing in the afternoon while taking rest in the field. Just beside the forest, there was a town where there was a factory. The owner of the factory, every now and then, was going to the village on his business purpose. He observed Seshaya reading and writing in the shade of the tree. He wanted to help Seshaya. Without being noticed, he kept some books at the place where Seshaya was studying. On seeing those books, Seshaya was shocked. Who kept these books? Shall I read them? Thinking so, he started reading. Then he got good practice in reading and writing. Slowly he learned to write in his own. The master felt so happy seeing strong determination. He gave him suggestions too, if needed. One day, while he was working in his field, it started raining heavily. The sound produced by thunder, the beautiful sight of lightning, sound produced by the drops of rain while falling on the leaves and on the ground, evoke a poet in Seshaya. With good rhyming words and following all notes of poetry, he wrote a song there itself and showed his master. He embraced him and expressed his joy. I am proud of you, Seshaya. Though you were an illiterate, within no time you are able to read and write. Now you reach the stage of writing songs on your own. Others take years together to achieve all this. How is it possible to you to write songs in this short period of time? It's all your grace, Guruji, said Seshaya, touching his feet. No, it's all due to your strong determination and hard work. His master congratulated him once again. The owner of the factory was once his student, so he shared his feelings about Seshaya with that owner. He too explained how he provided Seshaya with books, how he improved his skills of reading and writing. He explained everything. He further decided to bring out that woodcutter's talent. One day, he held a meeting in his factory and invited everyone, including Seshaya. He sang the song written by Seshaya. Do you know who wrote this song? He asked. All factory workers gave the names of different writers. Feeling shy, Seshaya stood aside. The owner of the factory called him. There was silence everywhere. He introduced Seshaya as the writer of that song. There was a big applause. At this age, Seshaya proved there is no age limit for learning anything. He is inspiration to all. His life should not be ended as woodcutter. I will give him a job in our factory, the owner of the factory announced. Seshaya's happiness knew no bounds. He fell on his owner's feet, went home, shared his feelings with his wife and his son. Feeling happy, his wife made delicious sweets and distributed them to all. His son Bhima's attitude also changed. I am proud of you, Dad. I am very lucky to have you both as my parents. I will go to school regularly and study well and get a good job, promised his son. Seshaya hugged his son and said, You only brought good change in my life, my dear son. The day became a festive day to Seshaya's family. This story reveals there is no age limit for education. The more we learn, much more we can learn, if we have the zeal. When we settle in good position, our children will also be inspired and move on the same path. Thank you. Jai Sri Manarayana.